Been trying to get this up for a while now. I finally got a setup where I could actually stream for the first time. Before I had my my laptop, I couldn't stream on that. But yeah, now we're set up. I got the webcam. I figured out how to kind of put together the stream, but I'm still learning, so you know, don't laugh at me if I'm messing up whatever I'm doing, because I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just clicking buttons. But what I do know how to do is trade. So if y'all got any questions, let me know. Be happy to give my thoughts on, you know, what I see. A lot of the stuff with trading is all based on your perception. So everybody's view of it could be different. Nothing's ever set in stone. It all depends how you want to see it, you know. Different people see different things. These are the levels that we've been watching right here. So this right here has been a nice little buy area where we've been picking up entering longs anytime it goes down to this area. And this one right here today got close enough. I like the 11,500 area to 11,600. So that's why I jumped in there. You know, basically, whenever I'm looking for entries, I'm just looking at what it's done in the past in the same area. I saw a lot of support here, so. What's up, Luckney? 1995. Who else followed? Chipmunk? Chipmunk, Luckney? What's up, y'all? Yeah, Chipmunk, definitely, man. Everybody trades differently, so there's no, you know, it's hard to say what's the right, 'cause it's not based on right and wrong. You can't, you know, if a system and a way to trade works for you, then it works for you. You know what I mean? It's not that you're wrong or another person's right, you know, 'cause you don't find that out until after it's over with, you know? So, for me personally, I like to trade price action. So I basically the main things I use is support and resistance. You know, and I look for momentum, and then I trade with the trend always. I do not trade against the overall trend. So as you guys can see, if you zoom out a bit, the overall trend's been up. So I have not taken any shorts. Like for me, instead of taking shorts trying to bet against a trend, I rather just not be in a position. So I'll just not be in a position. I'll sell, and then I'll wait for a better entry, basically. So like for example right here, like as this went up, I knew 12,000 was a point of interest where we get rejected. So I was taking profits there, and I entered a new trade above 12,000. But as soon as I saw a rejection, I got out, I stopped out, and I just waited. So I waited for this candle. Like, you don't want to be in this big ass mess. This is crazy mess to get into. You don't know which way it's going. It's a gamble. And then I let it sit for a bit. And around here probably is when I started thinking about getting back into trades, around this area right here. Main things that I trade is Bitcoin is my main thing to trade. I trade it mainly on Bitmex. I like to trade with leverage. I usually trade no more than 10x. I feel like anything more than 10x, you're more gambling than anything. Tezos, let's pull it up. Let me see. Do you trade it paired up with Bitcoin or USD? Because those are always two different things to look at. This is paired with Bitcoin. Yeah, if I'm looking at it, I'm not in a trade on this. Obviously, this right here is a resistance. Let me see if you look back, you can see this has been a point of interest right here. I'll pull it up in USD right now. Let me just look over it real quick at paired with Bitcoin. But if you look at it right here, you look at the past, you see this is a point of interest. So if I was trading this, I already know, like when I'm in this area, as soon as it breaks out, I'm looking back over here, I already know this is it's gonna be a resistance. So this is resistance, and up here is gonna be resistance. Both those area. And then once you pass this, like if you see this little resistance point right here, it was also resistance back here. And then this is going to be your next resistance up here. So it definitely still has room to run. Let's take it a little bit further back. Yeah, I could see this running up. Paired with Bitcoin, I could see it running up still a lot more. It's at 3,000 satoshis right now. Is that where it's at? Let me see. Yeah. So there's always going to be pullbacks. That's normal. It's healthy. I could definitely see it running back up to around this range. 3150 range probably. 3160, 3175. Got to break through there to get to 33. Let's check it out with USD. So at USD to, what, 367? Same thing, man. I just look at the bigger picture. I like to trade in the 4 hour, but if I'm analyzing something, I usually start at 1 month and work my way from there. The red indicator, I'll go back to that chart now. Oh, right here. I believe this one is the 20. There's a 20-day moving average. Yeah, I'll pull up Chainlink now too. But yeah, whenever I'm analyzing a coin, I do what's called a top-down analysis. I start at 1 month and I work my way down. So let me see. So this is definitely a point of interest. Then I go down to 1 week. And I can kind of see, zoom into where it was getting stuck. So $2.79 to $3. $3 is always, any whole number is always major resistance and support. The psychological. It looks like it's gone up to, yeah. So see, right as it got close over here to $4, it just rejected. Damn, it rejected hard too. It went all the way back down to a dollar. That's a huge rejection. Yeah, man. I've been running that trade group now. I started my trade group in 2017. So we have been going since 2017 in the trade group, man. Is it this a COVID rejection? Well, this one right here is a COVID rejection for sure. It was already rejected from before, though, it looks like. But it bounced back up at $1. Went up to what, $3. See all these psychological resistances, like that's always, look at whole numbers. They're always major factors. So as it's getting close to its previous high, it's struggling there. So a breakthrough of $4, it could take off. So if I was to trade this, let me zoom in a little bit more. Yeah, so if I'm trading this, I because right here you can't really guess where it's gonna go, so you're kind of in the middle, like you're in the open. It could keep trying to push up to four, or it could drop, and it has, if it drops, it has all this space to drop till about 320. So if I'm buying here, I'm not entering where it's currently at. I'm looking to enter around 320 or around $3 or 280. So I would set entries at 320, $3, and 280 probably, and anything under that I'm selling. And if I wanna, if it doesn't go down, you also want to have an entry if it doesn't reach your support, which is a breakout entry. I would be buying above $4 or above previous high. Previous high is 395, yeah. So I would set my buy above $4. Do I think BTC will be hitting 20K mark? It's definitely gonna hit it. Now I don't have a timing. I don't know. I never try to predict what the price is gonna do. I never try to predict the future. I just watch the price and I trade. I trade based on price. I don't trade based on predictions. You know what I mean? You don't wanna have a bias in the market. So you just wanna trade with logic, not emotion. I feel like if you try to make predictions, you're gonna be biased towards the way that you're predicting. So you're gonna be trading more emotionally than anything else. Yeah. So I don't predict prices. I do believe it's gonna hit 20K. When? I don't know. To hit 20K, we have a lot of work to do because we have to break through a few different areas. Let me see. Let's look at this in the monthly. So as you can see, we're almost at the highs of last year. Last year's high was 13,920. So we have to break, if like to go up from where we're at currently, first we need 12,000 to hold. If 12,000 does not hold, we're gonna keep dropping back to where we've, what we've been doing. We need to break 12,200 to, I think if we break 12,200, we could rally up to 13K. Then we got to fight that 13K resistance. And then we got to fight the all-time, the high from last year, from 2019. If we break the high from 2019, then our next resistance would be 15K, like the 15 to 16K area. If we break that, then we're going to hit 20. Now at 20, I think we're going to get a hard rejection, probably back to 15, 16. And then if we get the momentum again, we could definitely push past 20. I could definitely see that happening. Site do you use to look at charts? I'm using TradingView. They have an app, and that's the fastest way for me to look at charts. You could pay for it and you won't get all the little ads it does, and you could add more indicators, but because I don't use that many indicators just to trade, it doesn't matter to me. You love the breakout buys? I definitely love breakout buys, man. They're very simple and high probability setups, man. You gotta look for the easy setups. There's no point trying to make life hard for yourself, you know what I mean? People like to use a million indicators. I don't. I look for the easy setups. Yeah, Darren's been struggling at 400. It just cannot get a break. Cannot break through. It's done a bunch of fake outs. In our group chat, we've tried to enter it a bunch of times and we just can't catch a break. It's done a bunch of fake outs, so we keep getting stopped. So what I tried to do, we tried to enter right here, the 390 to 380 range, and then of course it dumped completely, so stopped us out again. I was trying to play this little support right here. So when it came back down, we entered and it dumped on us. And then it came back up. But yeah, so I like to trade Ethereum. I want to get back in, but where it's at currently, you can't. There's no entry here because it's probably going to be a fake out. It's going to keep. And so the only entry really, you have to either use a breakout entry, which is going to be around the last high. Most recent high was around 408, and what's this? And this is 415. So I don't know. I do something like over 410 probably. And then, but yeah, then you have to be careful. 415, it could get rejected like it did here. So that's why I don't know. It's a weird entry for Ethereum. So if you're looking for support, a support entry, then you're looking down here, which is where we tried to enter last time, which is around 390 to 380. See, this is a good support here, 390 to 380 range. It's held all this time over here. It acted as a resistance right here. That was just a bad dump where everything dumped there, so gotta just ignore that basically. So yeah, so for Ethereum, the way we're playing it, we have to look for a breakout or a support entry. I don't like where it's at right now. Right now at this point, you're just in the middle of nowhere, so I don't like those entries. What else are you guys trading? We've done a couple trades on BCH. How do you guys feel about BCH? We entered this one at 300 when it broke out. And we got to ride it all the way up. Took profit around 320, 325 range. Where'd it go up to? 326. Yeah, so we took profit around 320, 325 range. Stopped out under 320. And it dumped hard. 300 was. Yeah, 300 is a good entry for BCH. 375, nice. Yeah, so for BCH, I like the 300 area. So you see how it's kind of in a range here? I would wait for 300 again and have a stop. So you're probably going to want to have a stop under the most recent low, which is around 290. So if your stop is 290, yeah, you could have a risk reward of 2-1 at least, 2.5-1. You're gonna risk $10 to make a possible $20 to $25. So it's a decent trade to take. Alright, CRX. Let's go. Take a look from the beginning of time for ZRX. Just like to see what it's done in the past. Anytime you're gonna look to enter something, you gotta see what it's done in the past. As you can see, I remember this when it took off like crazy and it just dumped. See this resistance where it's basically at a resistance right now. So let's see. So it looks like the 42 mark, the 40 mark probably, 42 is its resistance. It's currently above it. Let's go down to the daily. This probably 45 and then 50, I'm sure. Yeah, so it's just before the 50. For ZRX, what do you mean waiting? Like you're holding it right now, waiting for those targets to take profit. Yeah. Yeah, so the first number I'd be looking at is 50. 50 is always a very, is a psychological barrier. It's always a psychological resistance. So I'd probably be looking to take, you're almost doubling your money at 50 cents. So I'd be looking to take profits around the 50 area. And then if I see a convincing breakout above 50, you could just buy back in. But I like to take profits at certain spots, at least a percentage of my profits. In case it dumps, I want to buy in again. Yeah, so 50 is a good point of taking profit. And then the high here is 56. Let me see what. This range is 79, 80. What's this over here? 70. Yeah, so it's basically the same numbers you're talking about. So I would do, instead of 55, I do 50. 70. Yeah, 50, 70. And yes, it's always good to take profit before the whole number. The whole number is usually where it gets rejected. So I take profit usually before. So if 70 is resistance, I'm taking profit around 68, 69. But it looks good though. Just needs to break out. This is like a big this is a big bull flag. Some days I wake up and I feel like I'm unstoppable, and then the next day it feel like it's all impossible. The world is at my fingers, but there's nowhere else I wanna go. And last night I finally hit my limit. You're welcome, bro. That was a good entry though. 33. Where's 33 at? Yeah, it's down here. Yeah, that was a perfect entry. Let's look at XRP. Anybody in Ripple? Bull flag right here. Absolutely no need for Aaron lungs. An Old Testament back to times when no one will pair him up. So please just for a minute put a hold on the snare and drums. See if I could. Moment to share the love. And if you're over, oh, this is terrible. Enough. I can't draw a straight line. Do you really want the gold or are you here for fun? Because if it's the latter, I'll happily end the banter. You can get bull flag right there. Live happily ever after. But I saw the way you got up this morning. So I'd be looking to since you stopped your recording. To buy a breakout above this. Let's look at in USD. Yeah, same thing. Same pattern. That looks like 32. Yeah, 32 cents. So you could do a breakout buy above that. You could also enter on here with a stop under the low. You might get stopped though. So if you want to give yourself a little bit more room, then under 27 cents. But it looks like it's definitely consolidating, preparing for a move. This is on the daily too. Yeah, right now it's at oh, I forgot to take this off. It is at the 29 cents, so it's battling the 30 cent whole number psychological resistance. So if you look at right here, rejections all around. Right here was support. Right here was just struggling with it. Indecisive. When it broke through, that's when I went up. That's what I mean. Above 30 cents is a good buy. You could also enter here with the stop, like I said, under 27. Do that because this right here was like panic sell. Boom, bull flag. So it's getting closer and closer to so if it continues doing this pattern, it should be reaching its apex by the 12th. So before the 12th, I would say, it should be looking to break out somewhere. I don't even know what day today is. Today's the 10th. So in the next 2 days, it could either break out or break down. Due to the pattern, the probability is to break out. So I'll be playing the bullish side of this if I were to enter it. I will be keeping an eye on it for sure. Yeah, same pattern as Ripple. Has bull flag right now. Mr. FRS, hey man, been following you for a while. Can you show step for step how you make the order for stop loss under 12K? Just want to make sure I don't fuck it up for a first time. Yeah, no problem, bro. So that's for Bitcoin. So, I mean, what are you using? What are you trading on? So because the first thing is you have to make a stop market order. You could do stop market or stop limit order. Right now it's at 12,000. So if you've already entered, so when trading, there's no exact numbers. You know, it's hard to explain to people, but there's no exact numbers. I try to simplify everything as much as I can for you guys. But you have to remember, these are just things to always keep in mind. When trading, there's no such thing as an exact numbers. What there is zones. So you're always gonna be using zones versus exact numbers. So when I'm using a stop loss on a 12,000, on 12K breakout, if I'm looking to set a stop loss, I'm gonna be looking anywhere between $25 to $100 from my entry price probably. So for this, for 12K, so you could play it two ways. If you don't mind stopping out and just continuing to enter it anytime it breaks out, you can set up a pretty tight stop. This is what I would do if I know I'm gonna be on the computer, or you know, somewhere where I have access to trading for the next few hours where I'm gonna be watching it, then I'll set up a tight stop. Because if I stop out, I could just enter back in. If I'm going to bed, I'm gonna probably set my stop a little bit wider, around the $100 range of my entry. If I'm gonna be around, then I don't mind setting it between $25 to $50 from entry. I also use a lot of the times the most recent low to look for a stop. So you have to kind of zoom into the price. So right now, like the most recent low is 12,004. So I mean, that's still over 12K. So you don't want to use that. So let's zoom in a little bit more to the 1 hour. What's the 12,005? I'm gonna go into 30 minutes now. I'm just kind of looking for a spot where I can where it's like a recent low where I could possibly put something. So maybe here we go, like 11. So 11,000. This is the low for 11,986. So this is a 30-minute. If you want to use a 30-minute low, you can place it under there. So I would place it around, you know, 11,980. This again, this is if I'm going to be sticking around for a while where I have access to making trades, I'll use like a 30-minute or I use a 15-minute usually. Like I'll use these two charts. If I'm watching it, if I'm at the desk watching it, I'm using these two charts, 30 minutes and 15 minutes for stop losses. If I'm not going to be around, like if I'm going to sleep, then I'm using wider stops. And remember, I'm re-entering the trade. Every time it goes back above 12,000, I'm re-entering the trade. Because I don't mind taking the small losses as I wait for the big winner. So right here, 11,600. We took one stop out and then we entered it again and we got the big winner, which made up for, you know, this little stop out. So I don't mind taking small losses for a big win. When you're taking profits, so the way to take profits is set up your orders as a stop. You can set up as stop limits or stop market orders, whatever you prefer. If you want an exact price, then it's a stop limit. If you want to just make sure that you're selling, then you want to stop market. Again, if I'm going to be around, I'm using stop limits. If I'm not going to be around, I'm using stop markets. Now with stop markets, you might not get the best price, but you're going to sell for sure. With stop limits, if the price goes too fast, it's going to... This is more if you're using a stop loss. If it goes down and you're using a stop limit and it goes down really fast, your order is not going to sell and you're going to be stuck holding a bag with a really big loss. So I'd rather use a stop market if I'm not around, because I know it's going to sell. Even if it sells at a bad price, I'm still going to sell rather than be stuck holding a bag with an even bigger loss. When taking profits, now I'm setting up, so let's say I buy 100 contracts. I'm going to sell, you have three targets, so you're gonna sell 25. What I do is I sell 25% at each target. So at 12.2, 25%. So I'm gonna sell 25 contracts. 12.4, I'm gonna sell 25 contracts. 12.5, I'm gonna sell 25 contracts. Now I have 25 contracts left. At that point, I'm holding the rest of that 25 contracts. I call that basically holding a runner for the moon. So if it continues to just take off, then you're just gonna keep making money on those profits on those contracts you're holding. If not, what I do is I trail it with a stop loss. So I have a stop under it, and I'll trail it behind, usually behind the previous target. So if I hit 12.2, I'm gonna leave it under 12 still. If I hit 12.4, now I move the rest of my position. Once I hit the 12.4 target, I move the rest of my my position under 12.2. Once I hit 12.5, I move the rest of my position under 12.4, and so forth. Once it goes beyond, then I'll just hold everything. The 25 contracts I have left, I'll just, you know, slowly move it up as the price goes up. And usually at the end of the last target, I usually use that as a new entry point for a breakout entry. But yeah, the type of orders, the way to set up the orders is with stops. You have to use stop limits and stop market orders. If you're gonna buy, if you're buying going long, you're gonna buy, and if you're going short, you're gonna sell. Did that make sense? Do you have any questions about that? Well, I would say if you wanted to use Bitmex to trade with leverage, and I mean you could trade without leverage as well, but only move 20% of your capital to trade. You know what I mean? Don't move all of your Bitcoin or all of your crypto. Just use a percentage of your capital that you want to trade and just use, you know, keep that somewhere. On an exchange where you can make quick moves. I use, like I said, I use a VPN for Bitmex, set to the UK. The VPN I use is called Windscribe. It is a free VPN. I'll type it in the chat. Yeah, cause it's definitely annoying with all the passwords and two-factor authentication and all that. It's annoying. Just keep a small amount and you should be fine. For the trades, if it's Bitcoin, I'm using 10x. If it's anything else, I'm using 5x. Yeah, for altcoins, you don't want to go above 5x because they move differently. So 5x for, like, whenever I'm trading Ethereum, I'm using 5x leverage. If I'm trading Bitcoin Cash, 5x leverage. XRP, 5x leverage. Only on Bitcoin am I using 10x. And if you're just starting, I do half of whatever I just said. If you're learning, do half. Don't do the whole thing. If you're just learning now, do half of whatever I just said. The idea is always longevity over everything else. So what happens a lot with traders, and the reason that 80 to 90% of traders fail and are not profitable, is because the majority of people come in thinking that they're gonna get rich overnight, and they do not understand the game that they're playing. You know, if you try to play a game where you don't know the rules of, you don't know how it works, you're gonna get run off right away. So you're coming to play a game that you don't understand, and you're not giving yourself a chance to learn. So the people that have been trading, they've been trading for years, you know, and the market doesn't care who you are, or how, you know, or if it's your first day trading, it's gonna eat you alive if you don't know what you're doing. So longevity is the key when trading. You want to set yourself up so that even if you have a bad month, you can still trade next month, you know what I mean? So that's why risk management is so vital. You know, risk management is what's all involved in risk management is making sure that you're using the correct position size. So if you don't have the link to the calculator, I have a position size calculator. I'll send that to you. Send me a DM and I'll shoot it over. But you need to have the correct position size, and you need to make sure that you're never risking more than 5% of your entire portfolio. And 5% is on a trade that you're extremely confident in. So you always want to be between 1 to 5%. 5% I only use if I'm like 100% confident, you know what I mean, 99%, which is, I rarely use 5%. I'm usually, and it also depends how big your how much capital you have. So like before, when I had under $10,000 capital that I was trading with, then obviously 5% wasn't that much. So I was closer to 5% on trades. As you grow over 50K and beyond, like, you don't need to take that much risk anymore because you already have a lot of capital to play with. So even with a risk of 2%, 1%, 2%, you're still making a decent return on any trades you're taking. So nowadays I only risk between 1 to 2% per trade. If I'm feeling, you know, loose, where if I'm feeling good about it, I'll go up to 3%. I haven't done a 5%. I haven't put 5% risk on my capital in a long time though. I could tell you that. 1-2% is where it's good for me, but again, it depends on, you know, how much capital you're trading with. No problem, man. No problem, dude. Appreciate you guys being here, man. We're coming close to we've been live for about 2 hours. Well, we've been live for about an hour and a half, but it took me half an hour to figure out how to get everything up and running. But yeah, I'm gonna wrap it up, man. This was the first of many more streams. I definitely want to do a lot more like this. And as we're saying this, Bitcoin is currently dumping. It looks like it's getting rejected here on the 5 minute. But I'm gonna do this at least. I want to do it a few times a week, possibly. I'm gonna be coming back with content for YouTube, and yeah, man, we're gonna be putting out a lot of stuff. I'm excited about, you know, what's going on with Bitcoin right now, where it's going. The fundamentals are great. The hype is coming back up. Yeah, man. And we've been buying. I don't know how long you guys been in the pay group, but when it was, you know, when it dropped to 3-4K, I was telling everybody to buy, man. You'll be traveling. All right, Chipmunk. I appreciate you coming by, man, and stopping by and hanging out with me for a bit. Love to talk to you guys, man. But all right, guys, appreciate you guys coming. I will definitely be streaming again in the next day or two. Not sure yet. We'll see if we get a schedule up. I will be out of town again this weekend, though. So if I stream again, it'll be sometime this week. But all right, guys, you guys already know where to hit me up. If you guys have any questions, send me a DM on Instagram. That's the one that I can see the best usually. Bitcoin.daily. Make sure to follow us on YouTube. I posted my the link in the chat. Also posted the Discord in the chat. And let's see how this trade goes, man. Hopefully we could break this 12,000 and this 12.2 and shoot up. If we break 12.2, we're definitely hitting 12.5 and I think 13K. So I'll keep you guys updated. Peace out, guys.